Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jen Hance, and today I'm going to be going over my skincare routine. So if you're starting off with makeup, I typically go in with some cleansing wipes. Right now I'm using Burt's Bees exfoliating facial cleansing wipes with peach and willow bark, made for normal to dry skin. They smell amazing and they get the job done wiping off all of that nastiness. I will go in with a cleansing oil. Right now I've been using Dermalogica's pre-cleanse oil. It really just takes everything off. There's like a light foam, and then I go in with a cleanser. Yes, two cottons, anti-pollution, oxygenated foaming cleanser. So this is great. It comes with this little brush that you could use to really just get in there. If my skin is feeling on the dry side that day, I will go in with Image Skincare's Vital C Hydrating Facial Cleanser. This really feels like a lotion on your skin. It's so soft, smells amazing, and it really like kind of wakes you up. I would definitely recommend if you are feeling dry that day or you're dry in general, this will help. This is exactly what I would use for acne problems. It's also anti-aging acne, so I thought that was pretty cool. So I've been using this every time I feel like breakouts are about to happen, especially when it's that time of the month, you know, just to really prevent and avoid any breakouts. That is my thing. The best thing that I like about this cleanser is that it has a kind of menthol feeling. So after you apply it and you like rub it in and wash it off, your face feels like a cooling sensation. And I feel like that is great to wake you up or just to really like feel refreshed afterwards. So the next step, I will typically go in with a toner just to kind of balance myself afterward. I've been using Fresh Beauty's Rose Deep Hydration Facial Cleanser. You could see that I've already put a lot of damage to this. I think it works really well, and it's also hydrating, so it's not a toner that really dries out your skin. Oh, bangs. So after I apply my toner, I just like fan myself out. Secondly, I go in with essence. I usually do the essence just at night as opposed to the morning because it's just an extra step of moisture. Most people forget about their neck. Necks are important. You don't want a turkey neck. So my next step is I go in with a renewing emulsion, Solwasu. I probably butchered that name, but this is their concentrated ginseng version. I've been really loving it. The smell is not like the most pleasant smell. After using that, I will go in it with a serum. So those have been standard things. I don't have alternative options for those things. Going into serums, I have tons of serums that I've been using and alternating just because I feel like your skin gets used to certain products, so you kind of have to mix and match depending on what your needs are that day, and then also to just keep your skin refreshed. During the day, I've typically been using Image Skincare's Vital C Hydrating Anti-Aging Serum because it's very lightweight and it really goes onto the skin smoothly, and then it also creates a good base for makeup. Dr. Jart's Peptin Radiance Serum. So this also has energy peptides, which I think is great to kick off the morning. I really like the applicator because it's a twist and it has a little button on top with the serum. And the best part is you don't have to put more product in here because once you close it, it automatically squeezes up. Intelligent Nutrients Time Traveler Serum. This is also great in the morning as well. So this similarly has the applicator and a button. The consistency for this serum is a little thicker than the other two that I just mentioned. Again, if I feel dry that day, I will probably use this one as opposed to the other two just because it's a little more hydrating. For my night serum, typically I've been using either Dr. Jart's Firming Serum, same peptidin. It comes with the energy peptide. Serum is a little thicker than the Radiance Serum, so that's why I've been designating it more for nighttime. Intelligent Nutrients Renewing Oil Serum. This one is a little thicker and it's an oil base, so it applies more sticky. So I think that wearing this at night is a little better than during the day, especially if I'm not applying any makeup. I don't want my hair like touching my face and getting stuck. So right now I've been using Image Skincare's Vital C Hydrating Eye Recovery Gel as a serum. So after that is done, I also apply a lip serum. Honestly, I've never heard of lip serums beforehand, but I think that it's been doing an amazing job at just prepping my lips to stay hydrated, especially during the winter. So I've been using Amore Pacific's lip serum. It comes in this little bottle. So after I apply all of my serums, at night I do apply a dry oil. So I've been using First Aid Beauty's Ultra Repair Cannabis and Oat Dry Oil. The next step that I love to do is take a jade roller from eDiva. It's basic, you could get one off Amazon. I stick it in my refrigerator. So then after I apply all of my serums and the oils, then I really go into my face and just apply it. And then I flip it to the other side to use the smaller one. This is good under your eyes. Lastly, I just roll up the neck. To be honest, does this work or do anything beneficial? I'm not really sure. I've been using it for maybe a month and a half now, and I just really like the cooling sensation of rolling into the skin. I think that in the morning at night, it really kind of just wakes up the skin. And I think that when you put the roller over the serum and the oil, it kind of makes it seep better into the skin. Yeah, having bangs is not ideal for like doing anything face related. So the next step, I go in with a renewing water. So I use Solwasu's, again, probably butchering that, but I use their concentrated ginseng renewing water. It's kind of like a thick water. That's basically what it is. So I put that onto my hand. I just apply it to the skin to kind of really seal in the serum and the oil. Don't be afraid to layer products onto your skin, especially at night. I feel that my skin has really been a lot better since I've been layering products and just having like a really thick amount of products on my face before I go to sleep. It's been really hydrating, my skin is plump, and it just makes your skin feel better. Whether it's really doing something, I'm not really sure, but I have found that layering your products onto your skin really make a difference. So I would advise just to figure out what works best for you guys. The next step that I typically do is I will go in with a moisturizer. I have tons of moisturizers. For the daytime, I've been using Dermalogica's Skin Smoothing Cream. This is kind of a thicker cream. It's really good for hydration. So again, if you are feeling dry, this is something that you should consider. It's been my daily, so I wear it during the morning and the nighttime. I do have other moisturizers that I use at night. I have First Aid Beauty's Ultra Repair Berry Air Cream. This is a really interesting cream because it's literally made with air. Texture is, it's filled with air, so I don't really know how to explain. Actually, those are my only two moisturizers that I've been using. So for today's purpose, I will be using my daily. Once I apply that, I'm kind of done with my face. I go in with an eye cream to kind of just finish it off. The eye creams that I've been using, I have two. First Aid Beauty's Retinol Eye Cream. It's very easy to apply. It has a little applicator, and I go in and just dab it in. The second one that I have that I've been using also is Amore Pacific's Time Response Eye Reserve Cream. This is a thicker cream. I use it when I feel like I need an extra sprucing, and it has a little applicator that you could apply it to and like smooth it out. I guess for this purpose, we'll be going the more hydrating route. Let's use the ring finger. It's just so uncomfortable for me, so I use my middle finger. Don't hate me. Lips. Let's talk lips. So I do have two things from Burt's Bees. There's a conditioning lip scrub that I use maybe once a week to kind of really just scrub away your dry lips, especially during the winter. Chapped lips are not fun. Assuming that my lips have been scrubbed this week, I go in with Burt's Bees overnight lip treatment. So it comes like this, and it's an overnight intensive lip treatment. It's a nice balm, and I just apply it. Ha! This I actually use my ring finger for. And I apply it to my lip. This really keeps my lips nice and smooth and waking up hydrated and refreshed. On occasion, maybe once a week, I go in with a sleeping mask. And I have several sleeping masks that I really enjoy using, and I rotate them. So I don't have a particular order that I like wearing them in. So the first one is Glow Recipes Avocado Melt Sleeping Mask. This feels amazing on your skin. And it's made with avocado. It's really refreshing and it smells good. So this is one that I've been using. Another one that I've been using is Laneige's Water Sleeping Mask in Lavender. Lavender really helps you soothe yourself and de-stress. So this, the consistency is really smooth and creamy and hydrating and lightweight at the same time. Like, I don't know how they did it, but that feels amazing as well. So really depends on what you're going for. The Glow Recipe mask is a little on the thicker side compared to the Laneige, but they both do an amazing job hydrating. Lastly, I also have Summer Fridays. I keep it inside the box because I'm special, but let me show you what it is. It's the Jet Lag Mask, and I haven't been using it that much or frequently just because I'm kind of afraid of ruining the pretty packaging, but I really like using this. This is definitely super, super hydrating. It really plumps up your skin. I used it a few times, and I could automatically see a difference within a few moments, so I think that if you're looking for something that is a game changer, this is the one. Other than that, that really captures my entire skincare routine. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. Give me a thumbs up, like, and subscribe, and see you guys next time.